England's Strongest Man here in Warrington Wolves Stadium, the Harwell Jones Stadium, rugby stadium in fact, for this massive event. We have 12 gladiators here in this stadium.
Yeah.
Going for Paul Smith's England's Strongest Man title. And he's not just England's Strongest Man at the minute, Martin. He is UK's Strongest Man as well, which comes with its own pressure in itself.
Yeah, it does. Paul's been putting in some really big performances. And he comes here today, you know, defending his title. When he's not someone who'll go out easily as well, he'll defend that title.
He will. And in event number one, we had the Farmer's Walk for a set distance, 30 metres. These guys had to lift these 150 kilos in each hand, Farmer's Walk, and carry them up a 30 metre course with no drops, Martin. They had a bit of a dead zone initially, but they had to lift them and walk with them as far as they could for that 30 metres, which is really tough.
Yeah, these cylinders, like, smash into your legs. You ask any of them athletes, that's the first thing they'll say. They whack your legs. So they're taking their legs away as they're going up there, 150 kilos in each hand, smashing your legs. First event, it's a baptism of fire.
It was a bit of a jelly leg event.
Yeah.
But we had two men who kind of were so, so close to finishing this event. In that kind of heat number two, we had Paul Smith, the reigning champion, 21-22 metres. It was absolutely amazing to see Paul kind of getting warmed up for this event. And Martin's going to tell us a little bit about how his prediction didn't really work out well.
Well, I had an argument with your dad. Not an argument, we're on the mics, but I thought Paul had done enough. I thought he'd worked out what the others could do, you know, heat three, to come out. And Paul coming out of heat two, obviously you can't see what's in front of him, but I thought he'd done enough because he dropped early. Your dad stated that he thought Paul had made a mistake, and we're going to find out if your dad was proved right or wrong.
Yeah, and event number one winner of the Farmer's Walk was Andrew Flynn.
I was wrong.
Flynn, the man who's renowned for speed events,
yeah.
But the grip, we thought the grip would have been an issue, but it wasn't. 27.82, he was so close to making a point in that event.
Yeah, he tripped up. Yeah, he actually saw the line, got excited and tripped up. And he even said himself, but he'd done enough, he did beat Paul. I have to say, Glenn Ross was right. Well done, Glenn. He knows a bit about strongman. And that's what he done. Fantastic.
Event number two was the block press medley, as kind of seen in the UK Strongest Man. 80 kilos, 90 kilos, 100 kilos, 110, and a massive 120 kilo block. Come down the time in the end, and the winner with 52.96 was Paul Smith. He announced himself in the England Strongest Man final.
Yeah, he did. He needed to as well. He needed a big performance. He got it. He looked for it. He got it. He used a lot of experience. And the thing is as well, you've got to look at the likes of Paul. He's done block press. He's practiced on, not practiced on it. He's done it at UK's. So he's had that practice time, you know, and he was good at it there. So, yeah, would you call it an advantage? Well, you can't say competing's an advantage, but he has used them before, got his hands around it, used his experience, boom.
Number three was the tire flip. The tire flip on this grass was not going to be a really, really difficult event. 400 kilos had to be flipped off 30 metres. Normally it's 20 metres, but my dad, the Danny Glenn Ross, was making it even more difficult for these competitors.
Yeah.
I really have. 30 metres of pain. And a really, really surprised performance. Two men that we haven't even mentioned during this roundup, Martin, were able to finish that course. And it come down the time, we had Dan Cave and Joe Oliver.
Yeah.
The fastest man in there was Dan Cave for 74.25. An absolute flying machine.
Absolute flying. Before I get to Dan Cave, let's talk Joe Oliver a minute. 19 years old, comes in. Smash it, he's a future strongman. You know, it was a wild card entry in UK, under 23 UK strongest man. You know what? He was fantastic, brilliant, finished it. But let's get on to Dan Cave. I'd heard a lot about Dan Cave coming into this competition. A lot of people started talking about him. Done strongman a few years ago. Went out, I think I'm right in saying he went out of the sport for a while, drifted out of the sport, and now he's back. And what a performance on the time. Do you know what? He knew, and I could see it in him, he knew he had to put a performance in on that event. If he didn't put a performance in there, I think the competition was pretty much done for him. Do you know what? He wanted to keep himself in it, keep himself handy in that competition, give himself a fighter's chance, and that's what he certainly did.
Yeah. Dan Cave was amazing in that.
Yeah.
And it moved on then to the deadlift. The deadlift, maximum, we started 300 kilos, which is no mean thing. That is unbelievable. I mean,
I think we do it a disservice sometimes, 300 kilos. And yeah, we're at a starting weight. You sort of expect everyone to whistle through it. But you know what? That's 300 kilos. That's a lot of weight. You know, it's a lot of weight. And I think we do it a bit of a discredit. It's the opening weight. You know, people can fail 300 kilos.
Yeah, I know. And we had 12 of the athletes here today. And all 12 managed to lift 320 kilos. Which, oh my goodness, we're talking about that 300. All of the men were able to lift 300 and then 320 kilos as well.
Yeah, they were going on. I thought, you know, I mean, it's a big day when you've got to start, you know, maybe looking at the starting weight being a bit heavier, isn't it? You know, but we've got some fantastic deadlifters and fantastic athletes. It's a good time in the competition as well.
And our second place in that event, let's move on to that first. There was two guys that actually were going for the UK record, which was currently set at Dean Evans, who'd done it in the UK Strongest Man, or in England Strongest Man last year, 400 kilos. And two men, himself, Dean Evans, who's in this competition, and Dan Cave that we just mentioned, both went for 400 kilos.
But different styles. Dan Cave is literally the whistle of go, and he will pull it. He will explode from the floor. Dean Evans, a little bit different. He's a bit more of a puller, you know.
A bit of a shrug.
Yeah, likes a bit of a shrug on it.
A bit of a statement.
But I tell you what he does as well. He looks more uncomfortable with a lighter weight than he does with a heavier, which is a bit strange. But he's a fantastic puller, no doubt about that. What can you say about him? You know, they went head to head.
They did, and it was Dean Evans who managed to equal his UK record. Believe it or not, 400 kilos. I mean, there was definitely more in him. But Martin, what actually happened yesterday? I believe yesterday he was deadlifting yesterday, and he deadlifted 430 kilos.
430. So he competed yesterday. Now, why? I don't know. Do you know what? I meant to ask him through the competition, but why did you compete yesterday? Why? But he did. Some of my money was actually on Dan Cave to pull it and Dean to blow out. And not through strength, but probably through Dean's stupidity of competing yesterday, you know?
Yeah.
But listen, he's not stupid. He knows what he's doing.
I believe there was he was a bit of a late call-up, actually, believe, this morning.
Morning?
He got in this morning.
Oh, well, there we go. That answers my question. I didn't know that.
Yeah, we didn't know that, but I mean...
Thanks for clarifying that, because I couldn't work out. You're not stupid. Sorry, I ain't stupid. I'll take it all back. Sorry, Dana.
I thought he'd known about it for months. There was Jack Osborne and Sam Duffy pulled out this morning.
Right.
Both Dean Evans and a man that we're going to get on to, Joe Bromley, Both of them put on really immense performances.
Well, I take it all back then. So he didn't even know he was competing. So he was warming up yesterday then on 4:30. No, take it all back. Credit. Blimey, that was good then.
It really tightened things up at the top. Event number five, Martin, was the Atlas Stones and the Glashan Stones. The Stones of Strength, we call it here in Ultimate
Whatever
Star
you
Man.
Want to call it.
100 kilos, 115, 130, 145, and a massive 160 kilo, that kind of 23 inches in diameter.
Yeah.
An absolute mammoth of a stone had to be lifted. They wanted to be England's strongest man. This stone had to be lifted onto that 4-foot-3 barrel. And there was three men who managed to lift that 160 kilo onto that barrel, which is really impressive. And I want to give a special shout out to the third place in that event. Bit of a last minute call up, no disrespect to the man. He should be in this England's strongest man lineup. And I hope this gives him encouragement next year to compete and to train, because he deserves to be on this stage. In third place with five stones in a time of 58.21. Unbelievable. And I didn't know he was a stone monster until today.
Yeah.
Joe Bromley, an absolute credit to you. So really well done in that
event. Yeah, well done, Joe. Brilliant late call up. Yeah, listen, what a performance from him. Phenomenal.
We've had two late call-ups and they've absolutely
smashed it.
They've smashed it. Yeah. There's no other word for it. It come down to two men in this event. Andrew Flynn and Paul Smith. Basically, it was near enough a winner-take-all in this event, which was a bit of a jaw-dropping finale.
Well, it was a jaw-dropping finale because I think the scenario was anyone in the top four at that point could have taken it up to the top, you know. So, and they were all first. They were all very fast to the full stone.
Yeah.
Everyone was fast. So the points in my head, I'm trying to work it out. I'm not a mathematician. I'll leave that down to you. But I knew it could really go anyway. You're going to tell us anyway.
And the winner in that event actually was Andrew Flynn. Andrew Flynn was the winner, his second event win of the day, with 5 stones in 32-34. And it kind of come down to time then. Paul Smith was in there, Lewis Packham, Dan Cave, those were the other competitors Martin was talking about there, who were kind of biting their nails thinking, where am I finishing here? And Paul Smith managed 44-01 for all of the 5 stones. So he managed to do that, and he was in for a shout for the title. So let's go through the overall standings here. It was tight.
It was tight. It was another one. He's so good. And when you are waiting for the result, and literally no one knows. And I normally look to Terry Ollins, because he works things out in his head. He's very, very good at maths. And I looked at him and he hasn't got a clue.
No,
didn't know. And you know, anyway, you're going to tell us.
Yeah. And in third place, we had Lewis Packham. Lewis Packham, the world's strongest barber, can call himself England's strongest barber.
Yeah.
Because he put up a great performance today. 46 points. He's done himself proud.
He's announced himself on the scene. I think he felt like he's arrived today. I think this is... do you know what? Lewis Packham being on the podium is no surprise to me. He talks the talk. He's confident. And do you know what? He works hard. So he deserves... Everything he says, he deserves it, because he works hard, you know, and he wants to be there. He wants to be the strongest man in the world. I've got no doubt about that. He wants the UK's title. He's going to talk it up. And why not? You know why? Because he works hard at it, and you know, he deserves that place.
And in second place, we had Andrew Flynn. Andrew Flynn, he's a bridesmaid once again.
Yeah.
50 points, brilliant performance, 2 event wins, just wasn't meant to be today. Andrew Flynn.
But what a good all round strong man he is now. He used to be fantastic at moving events, not so good at the pressing, you know, like. Do you know what? Them chinks in the armour, they're getting less and less. He's becoming a more well-rounded, strong man. He with every competition, he comes away with more experience. And you know what? You won't discount Andrew Flynn in any competition now, because I promise you, Andrew Flynn will be top of the podium. Let's look at the winner.
The winner and England's strongest man for numerous times. I don't know how many times he's won it quite a few times. Adding that to the UK's strongest man title once again, Paul Smith, 51 points. He's England's strongest man again, Martin.
He's hungry. Do you know what? I watched him. I watched him warming up. I watched him coming out for an event. He takes it so seriously. He really does. And you know what? He wasn't giving that title up today. And I'll be honest with you, he was made to graft for it. And do you know what? No one had been more happy that he had to graft for it than Paul himself. Because he wasn't given that title today. It wasn't a runaway. It was so tight. It could have gone anywhere down to the last stone. And he deserved it. And he grafted out a result. He showed a different type of strongman today. He had to graft the results out. And that's what he done.
He's the UK's strongest man. He's not England's strongest man. Can he be 2 times UK's strongest man? Martin?
We'll soon see.
If you enjoyed this video, like and subscribe below, and let's see some great comments of what you'd like to say. And if you want to go to an Ultimate Strongman show, get your tickets, ultimatestrongman.tv, and we'll see you there.